Good day, all. My name is Thiago. I'm an integration engineer at Cap4Lab.
Hello, guys. I'm Goran. I'm a solution architect at Cap4Lab. And what are we doing today here?
Oh my God, really?
Yes.
You don't do proper introduction. You don't. I know what we're doing.
Yeah.
We are helping our boss improve his driving skills. So he has a Camaro, he likes to take on track days. Anyway, we thought about doing something to help him improve. So we thought about collecting all the data that, you know, live data coming from the car while he's driving, and then we store it on the cloud. And then we can export it and render it properly, so we can actually look at what he has done and spot his mistakes, so we can, you know, correct them.
And what are we getting from this, huh? Build some APIs, some use of APIs.
Yeah.
We'll store it in Salesforce.
Yeah.
We will...
Python code to get the
You
data.
Will do some Python code?
Yes, that's fine.
Okay.
And then OBD. That's like fundamental.
And we get to drive the car, no?
Oh,
because we have to test.
I mean, exactly, we need to do a lot of tests.
Yes.
That's a very important part of any project.
Yes. Yeah, so I think we are good.
Yeah.
And we can also involve some people.
To
help to do our job.
Help us.
Yes.
Involve.
Yeah,
you know,
to involve in the project. Yes. Yeah. We start ordering some stuff.
Yeah. OBD and Raspberry Pi.
Okay. Let's get our laptop.
Go on. Start with OBD too.
You know. Okay. Okay.
First, you have the OBD that sends to the Raspberry Pi. So you order the OBD.
Okay, let's take the wireless one.
Bluetooth.
Okay.
That should do it.
This one should be able.
This one is fine.
Okay.
Yeah, it's
okay.
Indeed.
Okay.
That's cool. Raspberry Pi.
Let's go to grab one Pi.
Four, latest model, please.
Okay, so they are different. The most expensive one, company pays.
The most
memory. 8 gigs. Yeah.
I mean, we don't need the 8 gigs.
Quad-core. It's nice to have it. Okay, I think.
Yep, that's it.
Good.
Yeah,
should come soon. No.
Okay, guys, we finally got the OBD connector. So it just arrived this morning, and we are going to have some tests now.
Yeah, you can go and test it out, see if it's working.
Let's go.
Ah, here it is.
Yup.
Yeah. So it's a 2019 Chevrolet Camaro ZL1. It has a 6.2 liters V8 supercharged engine.
Yeah, it has 650 horsepower, 884 Newton meter of torque, and this specific model comes with 6 gears manual transmission. Not bad.
And to give it more downforce at the track, it also has the ZL1 1LE carbon fiber spoiler.
Yeah, good, good. We can try it. Okay, so we have the OBD reader. Now we'll try to connect it to the car. And let's see how it works. Thiago, catch. Bravo, Thiago, good reflex. Okay, now we're gonna try to plug the OBD reader into the car. Depending on the car model, it can be in different location. So it can be in the left side of the driver, in the right side of the passenger, in the gloves compartment. So in this car, luckily, it's just here. So all we need to do is put inside. You will notice a red light, and that's about it.
So the OBD is connected now. Can you make sure you're not the brightest? So I like to make sure. Good, okay, so it is connected. So we should be getting the Bluetooth. So we can find the OBD2 right here on our available devices. Let's start by connecting it. Ooh, asks for a pin. Very standard admin pin, just 1, 2, 3, 4. And we are connected. Great. Okay, now that we are connected via Bluetooth, so we're gonna use our free app that we downloaded called Car Scanner. So because of the Bluetooth version of this OBD reader, we can only use Android. So it works all the same. We just open up the app. There it is, now it's connected. Let's open the dashboard, get some data. There it is. We are getting data, so go ahead, start the car.
Okay, let's have some fun.
Yeah, go ahead. Aha, there it is, eh? Looks like it's working. Punch it, Goran, a bit.
Nice. Ready to go have some fun outside?
Yeah, let's go outside.
Let's go.
Let's go outside.
Okay guys, so now we are outside and we are going to test our OBD reader with the application.
Yeah.
And I think Tiago wanted to explain you something before that. Tiago?
I wanted to explain you. You have such a nice way with words.
Exactly, right?
So anyway, Tiago? You are not necessarily wrong. So what I just wanted to say is that basically all this data we're collecting is being generated by all the sensors that exist within the car. All of them, they're connected via a CAN bus, so that uses CAN protocol. They're all the sensors, the ECU, all of them, they're just nodes in the CAN bus. We're basically, with our OBD reader, plugging into that CAN bus. So the OBD reader just sends commands asking the bus for information. They all send it with CAN protocol to the OBD. The OBD gets all that data and sends it to our application via Bluetooth. Okay. And it does that constantly. That's why we get the data in near real time, because it's constantly asking for the instant value. That's why you can accelerate a bit and you can see the rotations here. See? They just go up. Yeah, we should try a bit more.
Let's have some fun
values.
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's go for the acceleration then. G-force.
And we should not do these shootings after lunch. I mean, it's a bit hot.
Come on, we can manage.
Yeah, we'll try at least.
Okay.
We can go.
Oh my god,
this can brake. It's nice.
It can, went to minus 3 G's. Okay, can you imagine so F1 drivers go to like 5.5?
Yeah, usually 6 G's.
It's crazy.
Okay.
That's why they have such strong necks.
I like these tests.
No, okay, so no, you don't like it. You just do it because we're serious people.
Exactly, yeah. We had to be smart and do this, test it on ourselves, yeah. I mean, it's not like we want to drive the car or anything.
There it is. There. Oh my god, this can break. It can also tighten my stomach.
I think we can...
Anyway.
Did we get some values, Tiago?
We did. all of this has been recorded there and here. So we can...
Let's hit it to the garage, boys.
Yeah.
Okay, so we are back at the studio. Let's do a short recap what we did in this video. So, firstly, we got the OBD reader. Then we plugged the OBD reader.
Yes.
Then we connected it to the application.
Yes.
And we received some data while driving very carefully. What's next, buddy?
Something. Stay tuned.
Anyway,
in the next video, we're gonna get a bit more technical. We're gonna take a look at some custom Python code that we'll be developing. Don't worry, we'll share the source code in our blog. We'll put the URL in the description, so you don't need to worry about it. We'll also be putting that Python code in a Raspberry Pi. The Raspberry Pi will basically replace what we've used the application for in this video. So we'll get all the data and export it to the cloud so we can do whatever we want.
Wow. Well, thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Don't forget to like and subscribe.